an episode of Witchy Goodness. So, on Ostara, I had planned on creating a project, a witchy project that's going to hang in my witch's kitchen. And it's a witch's ladder of sorts that actually looks like a ladder. It's not an actual witch's ladder, but it kind of is a witch's ladder. So that was my plan for Ostara. I went out and collected the wood. I went out in nature that day and spent some time in the park and collected the things that I would need to create this project. And I came home and spur of the moment, I was just like, I could live stream that and then just hang out with people while I make the craft. And I thought it was gonna be a really cool idea, and I figured I would come on and say hello and then turn the camera down and show you guys what I was making, right? So I posted it on Facebook and I was like, hey, who wants to hang out with me for Ostara and make a craft? And after I posted that, I started setting things up. Like, I started setting the camcorder up and I'm thinking to myself, wait a minute, how am I gonna live stream this? Because my computer is a desktop, it's an iMac. So I didn't have the camera, like the webcam, in the dining room where I'm filming, where the table is, so I could show what was happening down below. And I can't live stream from my camcorder. So this is not a very well thought out plan. So I was like, oh well, I've already posted it now. I'm just gonna go live and see what happens. So I went live. Oh god, dude. It was a complete clusterfuck. Let's just call it what it was. It was a complete clusterfuck. Because you guys couldn't see what was happening on the table, and because I was having to hold everything, it just, like, it was too much in my lap, and I hadn't really thought about how to make it. Normally, like, if I'm filming stuff like this, you guys don't see me fuck up. I learn by mistake. I fuck up a lot, but I edit all that shit out. I could not do that when I was live. Oh my god, it was so insane. It was a clusterfuck. So needless to say, I still don't have a witch's ladder. And again, keep in mind, this is not a traditional witch's ladder. We did talk about a traditional witch's ladder a lot on that live stream, but the project that I am making is not a traditional witch's ladder. But it is an Ostara project that I wanted to make, and you can put a spell into it, and a witch's ladder really can be kind of anything with the whole tying of the knots and the putting the things in and the spells, you know, all that good stuff. There was conversation about the witch's ladder, and there was really good conversation, but yeah, the project itself did not turn out. In fact, I only made 3 rungs and kind of showed them the idea of where it was going, and then I ripped the whole fucking thing apart and said, screw it. So if you want to see that video, I will link it down below, and you can go check that out. It's entertaining. You're not gonna like make a project, but it's entertaining. So I wanted to actually make the project and show you how to make it correctly, because like, as I was doing this, I started thinking to myself, oh, well, so the original plan was to have one long piece of string that was, you know, the spell was strung through the whole thing. And I've been wanting to make this project for a long time, but in Sicily, there is nowhere to gather sticks. You can't gather sticks to make shit like this. So I had to wait till I got back to the States, but now I don't have my Dremel, because the original plan was to drill holes through the ends of the sticks, you know, a hole here and a hole here, drill the holes through, that way I could wrap and then stick the thing through and tie. Yeah, it was supposed to have holes. But then because I don't have holes, I just wanted to make a temporary one just so I could have something to hang now. And I was just gonna wrap with the one piece of string and then bring it down. I don't know, maybe my brain just was not functioning that night, or I don't know what was going on, but I could not figure it out to save my life. So I have since discovered that maybe the single string is not the best idea. So I'm gonna put this damn thing together in the way that it probably should have been done in the first place, but in my brilliance, I did not see that at the time. But I wanted to create this witch's ladder of sorts. It's gonna actually look like a ladder. It could also just be called boho decor, boho chic, whatever you wanna call it, or nature decor. It's just a cute little project that's easy to do in theory. Not always so easy in execution. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna show you my supplies. I'm gonna bring it down to the table so you can actually see what the fuck I'm doing, show you my supplies, and then show you how to actually build this witch's ladder of sorts. And I'll talk a little bit about some of the stuff that we talked about on the live stream, but if you really wanna know more about witch's ladders and different ways you could build them, and some of the uses for witch's ladders, you can go watch the live stream. Seriously, don't plan to like make a craft. Just know that it's just gonna be like noise in the background because you're not gonna learn anything. It's not gonna be a very productive video. This one, however, by the end of this video, I'm gonna have a craft, damn it. So come on down to the tabletop and I'll show you what I should have made on a star night. Okay, so as you can see, I have several sticks here, and these were collected naturally. Wait, obviously they were collected naturally because they're fucking sticks. Oh my god. Harvested ethically, that's what I mean. Jeez, I did not go hack down a tree. These were already on the ground. They had fallen naturally. I did not break them or cut them, even though some of them look pretty smooth, which is interesting. These were all harvested ethically. They were all already on the ground, and I just gathered them. So I have my sticks, and I have some twine. For this project, you want to use preferably natural materials. So I just have twine and sticks. If you wanted to make it more colorful, I guess you could use ribbon, but or like baker's twine that you've colored in some way, but I would recommend using natural products. So just twigs and twine and feathers and rocks and, you know, shit like that. So, and what I want to do is move everything out of the way except for the ones that I'm using. And I want to figure out about how far apart I want these first few sticks to be. I think that looks good. And they're probably going to get further apart as it goes down, but I don't know yet. Now I want to start wrapping my first piece. So I'm going to take my twine and leave a little bit of leeway down here at the bottom. This is what you're going to tie it off with. And I like to wrap, I do things in threes, so I'm going to wrap it around three times. One, two, three, and then tie it off down here at the bottom. And again, I do everything in threes, so I'm also gonna tie three knots. Now, this is obviously not a traditional witch's ladder. However, you can use it just like a witch's ladder and put your spell into it, put your intention into it. You know, you could use these for protection, you could use them for prosperity, you can use them for family bond, whatever. But as you're wrapping, you can say your intention three times, and then as you're doing your knots, say it again three times, or you can do it just when you're tying the knots. But again, I do everything in threes, so I wrap three and then tie three knots, and then I've got this tail hanging down here. So now I want to figure out about how far apart I want them to be. And I'm gonna push the string together, and then I'm gonna tie it off up here again. Ooh, sorry, I know I'm off camera there. So now I'm gonna tie this one off up here. And I do three knots each time, so wrap three times every time, three knots every time. And
One. Two. Three. So there's the first part. Now I'm going to come over to the other side and do the exact same thing. So I'm going to leave myself a little bit of leeway here. And I'm going to wrap. Now, again, if you're doing this as a spell, you want to take into account which direction you're wrapping. If you're wrapping this direction, it's counterclockwise. If you're wrapping this direction, it's clockwise. You want to keep that in mind as you're creating your spell. This, for me, is not a spell, so it doesn't really matter which direction I go. I can wrap either way. But if you are working this as a witch's ladder or a spell of any kind, then you just want to keep that in mind, which direction you're wrapping. Even though it's not a spell, I'm still going to wrap mine clockwise. So one, two, three. Tie it off. One, two. Three. Okay. Then you want to make sure that it's fairly even. I'm going to have to turn my knot down to the bottom. And the tighter you've tied your knots, the more difficult that's going to be. So just keep that in mind as you're wrapping as well. And it might turn easy one direction and not so easy the other direction. So, I want to make them kind of even here and wrap. One, two, three. Push it up. Make sure it's on the solid part of the wood. And again, if you have a Dremel and you can drill the holes, that makes this whole process a whole lot easier. Okay. Make sure they're even again before you tie it off. Try to keep your knots in the same general area. That's going to help with the evenness. You can do this with driftwood. You can do it with wood that you find, you know, just random twigs that you find. You could do this with dowels or, you know, something purchased, but I really recommend doing it with natural items. So there we go. So now you're going to add the third one, and you're going to do the same exact thing. So you're going to measure how far you want it to be. You're going to wrap each side, tie it off, and then just build your ladder. So what I'm going to do is put all of my pieces together, and mine will gradually get larger as they go down. Oops. So my ladder will get wider as it gets towards the bottom. And then once I have the entire thing built, I'll come back and show you how to clean it up and then make it ready to hang. One other quick thing that I wanted to say is that as you're wrapping, once you get your initial three wraps around, if you want to conserve string, or if you're running low on twine or whatever it is, or if you just don't want the width of your twine to be too bulky, you can do your three and tie it off three and then wrap one on the top one and then go back to your three. So for example, you would do three here and three here to attach these two. And then you would do one here and then three here to attach these two. And then one here and then three here. So you only have to do the three one time. And then just to attach it, you could just do one, which will help you conserve on some string. And it'll also help to prevent your twine from being too bulky. Something else to keep in mind is if you are going to do the three and one wrap, keeping the single one on the inside, because these three will help keep each other in place. But if you wrap a single one out here, it could possibly fall off. So if you're doing the three and then the one, you want to make sure your single one is on the inside to wrap, inside of the wrap.
Okay, I have it all strung together, and you probably won't even be able to see the whole thing, but this is actually folded in half right here. This is double the length. Double the length, so it's really, really long. And I love it! So what I did was, after I strung everything together, I went back and just snipped all the little, you know, bits where I had tied it off and just cleaned it up a little bit. Once you hang it up, you'll decide if you want. See, like, I still have one here. I snipped all of these off. So just decide if you want to leave those hanging on there. It can add to the look. It just annoys the shit out of me, so I went through and clipped all of mine off. You want to make sure that you're not clipping too close to the knot, and you want to make sure that you're cutting the right thread, because you don't want to have to restring something. So mine, it's not completely even, it's not balanced, it's a little wonky, it's a little gnarly, and I actually really like it. There are two, so these are all fairly close together, and I wanted them to get gradually further apart, because the sticks get fatter as they go down. For the most part, they definitely get larger, so I wanted it to get the width here a little bit further apart. And I think I got maybe these two right here maybe a little bit too far spaced out, so I may restring these just to bring them up a tiny little bit, especially this one right here, because you can see this one's short compared to this one. I don't know if you can see, but just take my word for it. So I may restring this one, but I'm not gonna stress over it. I'm actually gonna hang it up and see how I like it, and then decide whether I wanna restring it or not. Now, once you get this thing built, once you get your ladder built, you can then go through and hang little things from the centers here or off of the sides, which as I collect, oh, see, it's coming undone. I think I cut too close to the knot. That's another thing, if you get too close to the knot, but if your knot comes undone, or if they look like they're gonna come undone, you can just add a little dot of glue on the knot itself, and that will keep your knot tied. I'm actually gonna have to restring that one little section. And if you have done a spell, if you have done this as a spell and you're concerned about that, you want to do the dollop of glue and let the glue dry before you cut off all those little stringy bits, because the last thing you want to do is have a knot on a spell to come undone. So just something to keep in mind for those of you who are doing a spell in your witch's ladder. You can go back as I collect other things. Like, I have a couple of feathers that I've collected since being back here in Sicily, and I have a couple of, like, those little gumballs. They're witch's burrs. I have a few of those that I might string into here, and maybe a stone. I have a couple of hag stones, and I collect random shit like that all the time. So I may go back and add little things, especially like some of these that are spaced further apart, especially the ones that are spaced too far apart. I might add a dangly bit in the center here, or maybe off the side. Just things that you can just keep adding to it, and each time you add something to it, you're putting more energy into it if you're doing this as an actual witch's ladder. If you haven't done the making of the ladder as a spell, like, mine is not a spell right now. I did not put any energy into this other than just the energy that I've put into it with my love and care making it. But now that it's built, I could totally turn this into a spell and charge it and empower it. And, you know, I could carve into it. Actually, some of the, look at this. Look at this. This is all natural. I did not carve this. That's just how the stick is. Look at that. Look at it. That's just how it is. But you could carve into it, you could wood burn into it, you could paint it. I like the natural look. I would not paint this, but I might carve into it. You can just impart the energy into it and then add little things that empower that even more. So, you know, feathers for different things and, you know, whatever. So you could turn this into a spell after you have the whole thing built. So that is my non-witch's ladder, witch's ladder. This is going to go into my real witch's kitchen. And the way you would hang this is just to add, you know, one more here, make a little loop. So you would have a piece of string like so.
to hang it with, which actually now that I have to rewrap this, I will probably just use this piece of string. So I hope you enjoyed this project. And like I said, if you want to watch the Ostara chat, it was on Ostara night, and I talked about the other things that I did for Ostara. I showed another spell that I did for with an egg. We talked a lot about witches' ladders. We talked a lot about Ostara and the different spells that I did and some of the different things that you can do for Ostara. So if you want to check that out, the link is down below. So just click that and it'll take you right to the live chat. That was a complete clusterfuck, but it was a good conversation. So that is it for tonight. Remember, if you like what I do here, don't forget to hit the little subscribe button. That way you don't miss anything. And click the little bell. That way you get the notifications from YouTube. Share it with all of your friends. That way they can hang out with us too. Remember, you are fierce, you are fabulous, and you are fucking badass. So keep that shit up, and I'll see you next time. Bye!